So I've shown you how to record your audio, how to distribute it, how to put it on centralized, decentralized. Now we're going to have a look at embedding that content into different places. So as I showed you briefly earlier on, you can go to anchor.fm and your account name, and you can embed from there. You can literally copy this, share, and copy that embed and drop that into your web page, HTML page. Alternatively, if you are running a CMS, and most people are running WordPress, or at least 30, 40% of people are running WordPress, there is a great plugin out there which I heartily recommend. It's about I think the minimum package is $8 a month, which sounds like a lot, but for what you're getting from this embed, I think it's worth it because you can search through all of your audio clips. People can download it and listen to it from the site. We've also got this really nice bottom area here where you can click on play and listen to the latest podcast while still reading the blog, which I kind of find really nice. That's over at smartpodcastplayer.com. Also, if you really want to do something custom or you're really, really pixel perfect and picky about the embeds and what they look like, there's some great other hosting sites as well. And you can still use things like Anchor as long as you've got the .rss feed link. You can pipe it into other stuff. One of those would be something like Transistor, podcast platform for brands who want to grow their audience. So they've got some different analytics, different stats than Anchor, although I know Anchor are working on some better stats. You can see from here, the average downloads per episode, estimated subscribers. Don't know if we get to see a subscriber listing on Anchor, but also you've got different things here, like the embeds are really nice. You can also get the podcast player, like I showed you. I'll quickly show you that. And also they give you branded websites. So if you're looking to make this a complete 360 strategy, that you have a URL for this as well, using something like Transistor, you can get a web page builder built from it and then just link your domain name to it. And every podcast that you put up, it automatically puts that post onto the page. So you don't have to have a WordPress installation. You don't have to have that $8 a month going out for that custom plugin player for WordPress. Maybe you don't run WordPress or don't want WordPress or don't want to. That's what the podcast player looks like. I think that's really, really nice. You can also embed it into a tweet. Another one would be something like Pippa.io, simplest, smartest way to share your podcast. And then finally, another one that I like is Acast. So it depends what you're looking for with your podcast. I kind of tried to do a rapid fire 30 minutes, 45 minutes mind dump of how we go about doing ours using Anchor and centralized and decentralized hosting. But any of these platforms are great for podcasting. If you've got your hardware and you've got that audio file, then it's just a case of finding a company that you want to work with, that you feel comfortable working with. Just do a little bit of due diligence, searching around on Twitter, looking for a host and what other people suggest. Depending on your niche, you may be coming across from a already established network as an Instagram influencer, or you have a big network on an application or an event management tool that you run, and you might have an audience that is 50,000 or 100,000 strong, and therefore you need a good host. I'm not sure with the free ones on Anchor if they allow big high volume accounts, so it's worth checking out depending on your particular niche. But hopefully some of those will give you a little bit of an overview. Like I say, if you're using WordPress, I've found that the Smart Podcast Player is probably the one best plugin out there.